The National Water and Sewerage Corporation Management has handed over the Katosi Water Treatment Plant and Insumba Reservoir after completion. However, during the Deputy Speaker Thomas Taiwa's visit to the facility today, it was revealed that the 240 million litre per day capacity plant is underutilized and 48% of the water generated is not supplied.
We have a lot of water, utilizing only 52% here, but you'll find people in Wakiso don't have water, people in Mukono don't have water, because water is only in reservoirs and it is not reaching people.
The National Water and Sewerage Corporation Managing Director, Dr. Silva Mujisha, appealed for support of Parliament to secure a 45 million euros loan to be able to fully operationalize the facility by doing the last mile connection in Kampala metropolitan area to reach the people.
Very happy that Parliament is promising to support us so that we can do that last mile of the project. And when we do it, we are sure we shall have the entire Kampala, Mukono, Wakiso fully served.
The Katosi Water Facility was established on a 300 million euros loan, which was obtained in 2011, but the corporation is yet to absorb 60 million euros, on which it seeks to top up with another 45 million euros to establish two reservoirs in Kanyanya and Kabulengwa Nansana. The Deputy Speaker pledged to support the project to evacuate the unutilized water to the intended beneficiaries.
We've seen is now that the plant is still underutilized because only 52% capacity is being utilized. That means that we have money lying idle here. So we must support National Water now to ensure that indeed the rest of the areas that are not yet getting water do get. And it's of concern to find water can be pumped, water is available, but people outside don't have water, you know. Someone can say, no, it's a huge plant and we are doing very well, but we want it to utilize the capacity.
National Water and Sewerage Corporation also used the opportunity to urge the government to revise their power tariff from the commercial tariff to the industrial tariff, which is subsidized. Currently, the corporation spends 800 million shillings monthly on power bills of Katosi Water Plant, which is taking a toll on revenue generated by the entity.
If we are put at that subsidized tariff that the other industries are using, we shall be able to leverage more funds to be able to reach more Ugandans.
In this regard, Taiwa has challenged the corporation to consider investing in solar power energy and generate their own power to guarantee sustainable power supply.
Support them on the issue of emergency power, because now they are just relying on umeme. If umeme cuts off, then it means we won't be having water here. And this is not water you would say you're going to store and keep for a whole month, because it will now start developing. I think scientists call them algae and all those things. Me, I'm a historian, but it will get contaminated, in short. So we would want to see that after investing in such a huge plant, we have 100% reliable supply of electricity to the plant, which will enable National Water to be distributing to the whole country.
The Deputy Speaker also urged the National Water Body to find social corporate responsibility programs for the surrounding communities by extending safe water and power to their households.
And when we go into an area and we put projects, the first beneficiaries should be people from that area. Otherwise, people, because they are your first line of protection, they are the ones who will tell us whether the project is working or not.
So I thank the committee and the government for having invested in money such that this plant is in place to ease the water problems in our districts.
Katosi serves over 7.5 million people in Kampala, Mukono and Wakiso districts. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.